Many European right-wing populists seek close relations with Moscow. Russia, for its part, hopes for the weakening of the EU and increased influence in Europe. For years, the FPÖ has been in favor of lifting the EU sanctions which were imposed on Russia because of its annexation of Crimea, and the Swiss SVP and German AfD have done the same. Exponents of all three parties have already traveled to the Crimea or Russia, where they have been hired as Vladimir Putin's useful idiots, because they broadcast their friendship with Russia on TV cameras, or because they act as election observers and thus legitimize the regime. It recently came out that the Russian presidential administration has long assumed that it can control AfD deputy Markus Frohnmeier. The FPÖ even signed a partnership agreement with Putin's United Russia Party in 2016. A similar agreement exists with Matteo Salvini's Lega. Meanwhile, Hungary's Prime Minister Viktor Orban maintains a close relationship with Putin. The two meet regularly and have much to discuss. Russia supplies gas, oil, and nuclear fuel elements to Hungary, and there are also good business contacts in the agricultural and financial sectors. For Russia, Hungary is also an important partner in the fight against the integration of Ukraine into NATO. In addition to ideological and personnel support, there are also concrete financial links between far-right parties in Russia. For example, the French RN party, headed by Marine Le Pen, borrowed 9 million euros from a Russian bank before the last EU election, the head of which bank is said to have connections to the Russian power apparatus. Meanwhile, Le Pen is said to have met Putin repeatedly. Among the European right-wing populists, however, there are parties that are extremely critical of Russia, such as the Polish governing party, PIS, which strongly supports the West's sanctions against Russia. For historical reasons and because of the geopolitical situation, Russia is viewed with suspicion in Poland and the Baltic states. Since the annexation of the Crimea and the war in Ukraine, fears of Russian aggression in this region have been high. The PIS manages to use these fears to its advantage. In the Baltic states as well, the far right does not see Russia as a friendly state.